Hi everyone, this is Lisa from Canine Clips, and this is Sam. And Sam is a Cavalier mixed with a Cocker Spaniel. So he is coming for a full grooming today. We're just going to give his body a nice little trim so that it stays nice and cool here. And then it also has time to grow out for before winter comes for us, which will be coming shortly, unfortunately. And I'll probably see him in the springtime again. So we're going to give him a number 7, as I said, and I'm just going to do some trimming on the feet here. He's got pretty fluffy feet. He's a little nervous, but you can see he's still pretty relaxed. Okay, you don't take a leash. Get the hair cleaned up there for him. Nails are actually pretty worn down in the back here, so I'll just have to take just a little bit off, but we'll see how it goes. I don't want to take too much. They're actually really healthy. There we go. We'll just trim a little bit off the ends. If they get lots of exercise outside, they can wear them down, but usually the fronts are still. So if they're pulling on leashes, they really wear those back ones down, but sometimes the front ones, yeah, there we go, don't wear down as fast. So sometimes the back ones stay nice and healthy from just walking, but the front ones still don't wear down. Although there are some dogs that really dig down in those front paws, and you can tell by them being worn down as well by the cement. A little bit sensitive feet here. He's kind of moving around a little bit. Might be a little ticklish. Lots of hair in there. This helps too, so sometimes you get dogs that have sap or pine needles or debris caught in there because it has that fur to stick to, so this helps the dogs not pick up as many materials because it has nothing to stick to in the fur there. All right, it's okay. Come on. Good boy. You all took a puppy. lay down on my feet. I'm gonna do it on the other side. So if you like this video and you'd like to see more, please subscribe to my channel. I do have lots of videos on my channel of different dog breeds that I groom. I also have some playlists of specific grooming techniques or holds on the different breeds, but different situations. So I have just, I started some just for matted dogs, or just how to clean the ears or do the nails. So you can kind of just zone in on what you're specifically looking for. You can also send me a comment in any of the videos if there's something specific you'd like to see, and I can try to get that on for you. I'm really looking for subscriptions right now, so if you are have been watching my videos and do enjoy them but just haven't subscribed yet, I'd really appreciate that. He's a little shy there. Where is he? Hey there, buddy. Okay. No. When a dog licks, sometimes when I'm grooming, it can be a sign of aggression. But just by the way he's doing it, I'm not worried about it because it's a different type. I don't know, it's just a different type. So some of them I would be concerned and some I'm not. So I guess just after doing it for 16 years, you get to read them a little bit more and know. See, there you go. Hey, no. To know he's getting fed up with me, but he's not necessarily a biter, but I guess that could change. So you just always got to be on alert if the dog's licking you when you're grooming. It's not necessarily a sign of affection. But sometimes it's a way to try to get you to stop. A little bit of distraction. Okay. Come on. One more. And then the duplo. Come on. There you go. Good boy. Okay. Last paw, buddy. And this one's got the fur pretty good in there, too. Okay. There's nails. Okay, so these back ones are pretty much the same as the other ones. So I'm just going to take just the tips off. Because they are nice and healthy. Nice length, so I don't need to take a whole bunch off. There we go. Good boy. All right, so I'm just going to comb out the ears and the tail right now before the bath. And actually, I'm going to, in the cocker's ears, they get really lots of fur in there. Just give me a little, I'll show you on this side. So I do like to shave that down so that it stays a little bit lighter for them. So I will do that here before the bath as well, just so I can get in there and get nice and clean. Since he's staying here for me, I might as well do it now. And then that way it keeps the ears a little bit lighter. I'm just going to do the inside, not the outside. So the outside, we're going to keep that layered look. There we go. One, buddy. Come on, Sam. There you go. There we go. We can come back after and finish the rest of that up. And I'm going to trim in here and then do any plucking. Just got a little bit of hair in there, but not too much, so I'll get that out. And I just want to make sure I trim with the outside ear canal here, so that... because that ear hair is quite thick, but inside the ear canal comes out quite easily, so you don't want to accidentally pick the wrong one. So I like to make sure I trim that so I don't accidentally grab that. And he doesn't have too much hair in his ears. His ears are actually very healthy. Look really good. See, not very much. We'll trim this side the same. Hold on. Just about done. There you go. There you go, buddy. Yeah, let's make sure we got it. Yeah, good. Okay, so we'll leave that. And then I'll comb out the tail. A little bit of matting in there, so I'm going to thin it out a little bit. So I'm not pulling as much on him. since there's mats there, I'm also thinning it out in different areas as well. So we don't have to worry about mats coming back as much. And it is pretty thick tail as well, so. There you go. Yeah, so quite a bit in there, and it is quite thick for. So I like to do comb it out before the bath, because it is a lot harder to comb this out when it's a bit damp. Just getting through it now. Okay. I'll just give the tail a little trim, and then he's ready for the tub. Massage. That's his sister Sophie in the back room there. letting us know she's there. Hey, come on. She's so stiff. Get all that dirt off. Okay, baby. There you go, bud. Okay. Okay, we're gonna move back to the table. There you go. Okay. So now we're going to give this guy a blow dry. Get him all dried up a bit. Choo-choo. Thank you. number 7 cat. I'm gonna include the top of the head when I'm doing that. But just leave the ears so that they have a little bit more poof on them, or layering, I guess. Okay, I'm going to get him to stand. Hopefully, yeah, good boy. Okay. Good boy, Hexay. I'll feel a little bit up here, but I'll come back with the number 10 in that area. Give it a little cleaner look. Okay, I'm just gonna make it uncool the blade still, so I'm not worried about that, but I'll just get the fur so it gives it's not clogged up there. Get that out of there. And obviously you can spill a little bit here. Yeah. Okay. This fur is actually pretty thick, so it is nice that it's a little bit damp, so it can keep the clipper blades nice and cool. And I know I always say what blade I'm using, but I always use a skip tooth blade. That helps get through everything a little easier. And even when I'm finishing, I use the 7. Skip tooth. I don't use any finishing blades. Obviously, the number 10, you can't get it in a skip tooth, and the 3/4 inch blade you cannot get in a skip tooth. But other than that, all the rest of my blades are skip tooth. It really helps when there's a matted dog, or they have thick fur like this too. And it really still leaves a nice clean finished look as well. That's alright. So I always do go over the dog twice, so maybe that helps, but I would always be doing that anyway, so yes. Okay. One up. And I clean up his bum with a number 10 as well. Come on. And I'll shave him up a little bit with my other arm there. Yeah, good boy. Okay. Yeah, I always wear a mask. I do that for the hair particles flying around, especially when I'm blow drying, but even if they shake, so I'm not breathing that in, just to help protect my lungs. I think when I first started grooming, and I always have a scummy throat after grooming, didn't know why, but that's why. All those little fine hairs from the doggies. Just one way to help ensure that I can keep doing this for a long time. You can hear the clippers change sound there, so I'm going to add some clipper oil. May or may not help there. Let's see if there's any fur cotton there. But they're not hot, so. Might just be getting dull a little bit. Oh, yeah, I'll just move the camera. Okay. Okay, there you go. Good boy. Alright, so what I'm going to do now is just give them another quick little blow dry after I clean off this table. See what I may have missed. Excuse me. Put that on. Okay, here we go. See, I missed kind of like that, so a little piece here and there. So I will get the number 7 out again, and we will finish him up. Again, I'm using the skip tooth. Okay, I think we got it all now. Okay, so let's comb up these ears again. Just give them a little bit of a trim. And I'm gonna give them a little bit of a blow dryer too. I'll trim them up first and comb out the tail. Blow dry the ears just to make sure they're nice and layered. There you go. When I do blow dry those ears, I make sure I push them down so I make sure no air gets inside the ear canal. There, and then I can see a little bit nicer here to layer it downward. There we go. All right, so there is our cut on Sam. So thanks for taking the time to watch, and please subscribe if you haven't done so already. And let me know if you'd like to see something different. And I appreciate your time and hope you're having a great day. See you again. Later.